हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल। सो इन दिस वीडियो आई वुड लाइक टू डिस्कस ऑल द मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चन ऑफ कॉस्ट अकाउंटिंग फ्रॉम क्वेश्चन नंबर 401। आई हैव ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड डिस्कशन अप टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 400 इन द लास्ट वीडियो, एंड नाउ इन दिस वीडियो we would like to start from question number 401. Okay, so without any further delay, let's get started. Current ratio is the ratio of current asset to current liability. Current ratio is the ratio of current asset to current liability. Okay, then question number 402. In standard cost, DAS norm is applied as a scale of reference for assessing actual cost to survey as a basis of cost control. So, हम लोगों को पहले से ही पता है कि predetermined norm always followed or applied as a scale of reference for assessing actual cost to survey as a basis for cost control in standard cost. So this question is very important. Then question number 403, material transport node MTN is a DAS for transferring the materials from one job to another. The right answer will be document. Transport node MTN is a document for transferring the materials from one job to another job. Question number 404. One of the disadvantages of overtime working is incurring DAS labor cost. Right answer will be excess. One of the disadvantages of overtime working is incurring excess labor cost. Then question number 405. CAS-2 deals with cost accounting standard on DAS determination. Right answer will be capacity determination. CAS-2 deals with capacity determination. Okay, then question number 406, where the cost and financial accounts are maintained independently of each other, it is indispensable to DAS them as there are difference in the profit of two set of books. The right answer will be reconcile them. Where the cost and financial account are maintained independently of each other, it is indispensable to reconcile them in order to know the difference between profit of two set of books. Okay, then question number 407, maximum level is equal to DAS plus reorder quantity minus minimum consumption rate into minimum reorder period. So right answer will be reorder level. Maximum level formula is reorder level plus reorder quantity. Reorder level plus reorder quantity minus minimum consumption rate into minimum reorder period. Right, then question number 408, CS8 deals with the principles and methods of determining the DAS. Right answer will be cost of utilities. CS8 deals with the principles and methods of determining cost of utilities. Question number 409, store ledger is kept and maintain in DAS office. Right answer will be cost office. Then question number 410, in a company there are 1200 employees on the roll at the beginning of a year and 1180 at the end. During the year, 120% are left from service and 96 replacement were made during the year. Then the labor turnover to flux method is how much? So as you know that the labor turnover according to flux method is half into number of additions plus number of separation, half into number of additions plus number of separation divided by average number of workers into 100, half into number of additions during the year plus number of separation during the year divided by average number of workers. So in this way you can do it. half into number of addition is how much? Number of addition 96 and number of left 120 divided by average number of worker in 100. So after calculating with this formula, we obtain that 108 into 100 divided by 1090, right answer will be 9.08. So you just need to remember the formula. If you know the formula, then you can easily calculate. The formula of flux method is half into number of additions plus number of separation divided by average number of worker into 100. Okay, then question number 411. Ideal time arises only when workers are paid on dash basis. Ideal time arises only when workers are paid on time basis. Right. Then question number 412. Normal ideal time cost should be charged to dash while that due to abnormal reason should be charged to dash. As you know that normal ideal time cost should be charged to production overhead while that due to abnormal reason should be charged to costing profit and loss account. Normal ideal time should be charged to production overhead. While due to abnormal reason should be charged to costing profit and loss. Right. Then this question is very important. Then question number 413. Direct expenses incurred for brought out resources should be determined at dash. Right answer will be invoice price. Direct expenses incurred for brought out resources shall be determined at invoice price. Then question number 414. Direct expenses incurred in lump sum shall be dash. Right answer will be amortized. Direct expenses incurred in lump sum shall be amortized. Okay, question number 415. Overhead incurred rupees 16,000 and overhead absorbed rupees 15,300. Then there is under absorption of dash. Right answer is 700. Overhead incurred rupees 16,000 and overhead absorbed rupees 15,300. And there is under absorption of 700. Okay, then question number 416. Under integrated accounting system, the accounting entry for payment of wages is to dash and to credit cash. Under integrated accounting system, the accounting entry for payment of wages is to debit wages control account and to credit cash. Then question number 417. Two principal method of evaluation of equivalent are dash and dash. Right answer will be one is first in first out and another one is average cost method. The two principal method of evaluation of equivalent production are first in first out FIFO and average method. And two principal method of evaluation of equivalent production are first in first out and average method. Okay, then next question. Question number 418. Ye bhi very important and very easy question also. When sales are rupees 3 lakh, variable cost 1 lakh 80, then profit volume ratio will be how much? Very easy, very simple question. Contribution, as we know, the PV ratio formula is contribution by sales into 100 and contribution formula is sales minus variable cost. So here sales value given 3 lakh, variable cost given 1 lakh 80. So if we subtract variable cost from sales, we obtain contribution. So in this way, we find out that three lakh minus 1 lakh 80 is equal to 1 lakh 20,000 divided by 3 lakh into 100 is equal to 40%. So the right answer is 40%. Okay, Then question number 419. Goods received note is prepared by the dash department. Right answer is receiving department. Good received note is prepared by the receiving department. Okay. Then question number 420. Transfer of surplus material from one job or work order is recorded in dash. Right answer is material transfer note, MTN. Material transfer note, short MTN. Material transfer note is a note which is transfer of surplus material from one job or work order is recorded in material transfer note. Okay. Jo bhi transfer of surplus ho raha hai from one job or work order to another is recorded in material transfer note. Then dash is discount allowed to the bulk purchaser. Right answer is quantity discount. Quantity discount is given to bulk purchaser. Okay. Then question number 422. Dash is a document which records the return of unused materials. Right answer is material return note. MRN. Material return note is a document which records the return of unused material. Material return note is a document which records the return of unused material. Question number 423. In dash systems, two piece rates are set for each job. Right answer is Taylor differential piece rate. Taylor's differential piece rate systems. In Taylor's differential piece rate systems, two piece rates are set for each job. Question number 424. The formula for computing wages on the time rate is dash. Right answer is hour work into rate per hour. The formula for computing wages under time rate is hour work into rate per hour. Right. Then question number 425. In Halse plan, a worker gets bonus equal to dash of the time saved. In Halse plan, a worker gets bonus equal to 50% of the time saved. In Halse plan, a worker gets bonus equal to 50% of time saved. Right. Then question number 426. Under Jan task and bonus plan, no bonus is payable to a worker if his efficiency is less than dash. So right answer will be 100%. Under Jan task and bonus plan, no bonus is payable to a worker if this efficiency is less than 100%. Okay. Then question number 427. Wages sheet is prepared by dash department. Right answer will be payroll department. Wages sheet is prepared by payroll department. Right. Question number 428. Diet expenses related to dash or dash. Diet expenses related to, as we know, manufacturing of a product or rendering of service. Question number 429. Penalties or damages paid to statutory authorities dash be form of part of diet expenses. Penalty damages paid to statutory authorities shall not be form part of diet expenses. अगर कुछ भी पेनल्टी या डैमेजेस पेड हो रहा है टू स्टैट्यूटरी अथॉरिटीज देन इन दैट केस दैट शुड नॉट बी फॉर्म पार्ट ऑफ डायरेक्ट एक्सपेंसेस ओके देन दिस वन इज इम्पोर्टेंट देन क्वेश्चन नंबर 430 ए डायरेक्ट एक्सपेंसेस रिलेटेड टू ए डैश फॉर्म पार्ट ऑफ द प्राइम कॉस्ट राइट आंसर इज प्रोडक्ट ए डायरेक्ट एक्सपेंसेस रिलेटेड टू प्रोडक्ट फॉर्म पार्ट ऑफ द प्राइम कॉस्ट राइट Question number 431. Overheads are an aggregate of dash and dash and dash. Right answer will be indirect material, indirect labor, indirect expenses. You can write insert overhead and an aggregate of indirect material, indirect labor and indirect expenses. Right. Then question number 432. Example of after sale service are dash and dash. Example of after sale service are repair and maintenance and replacement of components. Example of after sale service are repair and maintenance and replacement of components. Then question number 433. Administration overheads are usually absorbed as a percentage of dash. Right answer is work cost. Administration overheads are usually absorbed as a percentage of work cost. Then question number 434. The difference between actual and absorbed factory overhead is called dash. Right answer will be overheads. The term used for charging of overhead to cost unit is known as absorption. The term used for charging overhead to cost unit is known as absorption. Then question number 436. The difference between practical capacity and the capacity based on sales expectancy is known as ideal capacity. Ideal capacity. The difference between practical capacity and the capacity based on sales expectancy is known as ideal capacity. Right. Then question number 437. The dash rate is computed by dividing the overhead by the aggregate of the productive hours of direct worker. Right answer will be direct labor hour. The direct labor hour rate is computed by dividing the overheads by the aggregate of the productive hours of direct workers. Then question number 438, under or over absorption of overhead arises only when overheads are absorbed by overhead rates. Under or over absorption of overhead arises only when overheads are absorbed by overhead rates. Then question number 439, overhead incurred ₹16,000 and overhead absorbed ₹15,300, there is under absorption of 700. Overhead incurred ₹16,000 and overhead absorbed ₹15,300, there is under absorption of 700. Question number 440, in absorption costing, dash cost is added to inventory. Right answer will be fixed. In absorption costing, fixed cost is added to inventory. Then question number 441, prime cost plus overhead is equal to total cost. As you know that prime cost plus overhead is equal to total cost. Then question number 442, dash plus profit is equal to sales. As we know that cost of sales plus profit is equal to sales. Cost of sales plus profit is equal to sales. Then question number 443, direct material plus dash plus direct expenses is equal to dash. Is equal to prime cost. Right answer will be direct wages. Direct material plus direct wages plus direct expenses is equal to prime cost. Right. Then question number 444. Salary paid to factory manager is an item of dash. Right answer will be factory overhead. Salary paid to factory manager is an item of factory overhead. In reconciliation, while preparing reconciliation statement between cost account and financial account, income shown only in financial account are added to costing profit. Income shown only in financial account are added to costing profit. To make it equal with financial account, so we need to add cost to costing profit. Okay, then question number 446. In a reconciliation, doing reconciliation between cost account and financial account, expenses shown only in cost accounts are added to costing profit. Expenses shown only in cost account are added to costing profit. This one is important. In reconciliation, overhead over recovered in cost account are reduced from costing profit. When overheads over recovered in cost accounts are reduced from costing profit. While preparing reconciliation between cost account and financial account, overheads under recovered in cost account are added to financial profit. This one is important. When overhead under recovered in cost account are added to financial profit. Okay, then question number 449, notional remuneration to owner his expenses debited only in dash. Right answer will be cost account. Notional remuneration to owner is expenses debited only in cost account. Then question number 450. All the transactions relating to materials are recorded through dash. The right answer will be store ledger control account. All the transactions relating to materials are recorded through store ledger control account. Okay, so with this I have completed up to question number 450. Okay, iske next video mein hum log start karenge from question number 451. So thank you so much for your time and thank you so much for your support.